Well, folks, I'm in the workshop. I've been doing working on this trotter mower I'm working at. You can see that on my Retro Restore channel. And I'm not very well. I've not been well for a few days since we come back from Scotland. But while I've been in here tinkering, Sharon's outside. She's built something. Let's go and have a look and see what she's done. Well, as I've said, it's a lovely day out here today. And she's been out here with little Harry. And she's built this swing chair. So there we go. Our daughter bought us this. Oh, when was it? Christmas?
Yeah, Christmas.
So you've decided to put this together. You do a lot of swing chair. I'm not really too bothered about them, but she loves them. She was on it all the time out in Cyprus. And Harry's helped her as well.
We've done it together.
And what's he doing, Sharon? Look, lunatic here.
He's eating a couple of these caps.
The caps?
These little black things, yeah.
Oh, he's a nutcase, that dog. You've done very well, Harry. You deserve a Blue Peter badge. You don't know what that is, do you? What's that supposed to mean?
It's my mate.
I don't know what he's doing down there, Sharon. Look, he's going blinking. Hey, it's shadows. Look again. Merlin. Leave the shadow. See that shadow on the floor? Look. He's jumping on there for the shadow. Look. He's unbelievable. So it didn't take you long, really, baby, did it?
Well, it says it's a two-man job. It takes 70 minutes for two adults. And we've done it just over 70 minutes.
Well, you ain't done bad.
We've done excellent, me and Harry.
Yeah, it's a bit windy out here, mind you. But the garden's looking all right. And as you remember, eh?
I'll talk to Harry.
Oh, carry on then. Look at Dougal down there, look. But coming round here, folks, I did do a trotter mower a couple of years ago, I think, and we haven't used it. And this was painted, actually. I did paint that one, but I say we haven't used it. We have used it a couple of times, but yeah, that was the trotter mower I've done a restoration on. But yeah, we've got this other one now, and it's looking good. Look at these trees coming back into blossom now, look. Look at that little pear tree there, look, conference pear. Tulips. So, bank holiday Monday, and Sharon's had it. We've had that sore throat, Sharon, haven't you?
Yeah.
The cough and various things. And I've had it now, and it comes on worse at night, so just taking it easy. You ain't got no energy at all, Sharon, have you?
No.
Well, I haven't anyway. Yeah, we want to show you this air fryer. We're so impressed with this air fryer. We're going to do a little bit of a cook-off with you. It'll probably be a little bit later on in this video, but we've cooked stuff in there which sticks to the frying pan normally, or breaks up in a frying pan, or you know when you put something on a tray in the oven, like chicken nuggets, and you always get a soft bottom on them, and they always stick to the
soggy bottom.
So what's it called? The silver foil or something, don't they? And they're never nice, are they?
No.
And it's fantastic in the air fryer. And you've done a full fry up in it, Sharon, didn't you?
Yeah.
Apart from the eggs, beans and tomatoes or whatever, but she's done absolutely everything in the air fryer and it takes a fraction of the time. Where are you going, baby?
I
want
to get these fingernails out, so I think
this is... Oh, pull them out, yeah. What was in there, Sharon?
My begonia.
Wait, Dougal, Merlin, out.
No, it's not begonia, it's...
You got to pull them out by the roots, baby.
Hyacinth.
Look how quickly they grow, Sharon, look.
My tulips, people know that I lost my granddaughter Olivia, or our granddaughter. And
that was her tulips.
Gave tulips and seeds out, and these are her tulips.
Yeah.
And over here, I just chucked a load of forget-me-nots. Come over here.
I forgot how.
Forget-me-not seeds.
Yep.
I've slung them over here.
Oh, what, on our rough part of the garden?
Look.
This is our meadow part. We call it the meadow part of the garden.
I'm trying to make it like wild, and this is all over little Olivia's forget-me-nots.
Oh, yeah, lovely.
I just went like that.
Well, that's normally where I throw the dog poo, Sharon.
I'll throw it over there if I can.
Yeah.
But I want to clear this because Jimmy and his mate are doing the fence.
What do they do at the fence?
Spraying it.
Oh, with the old hand spraying thing he's bought, isn't he? Yeah. We're going to go for the dark oak colour now, aren't we? All that ivy's shout. All that ivy's got to come down.
I know, yeah. I can't do everything.
No, I'm not asking you, baby. I said I would probably do it.
I've started on bits.
Shout. I'm here for you, baby.
We're going to do your lawnmower. Go on, I'm waiting to see this finished.
Yeah, well, I'm a bit not well at the moment.
I thought you'd been working.
Shout. I've got all the graphics on it now, baby.
Well, you have been working.
Of course I've been working. I don't just stand here do nothing, baby. Walk out the door and then start filming with nothing done. They've already seen it. They've already seen it, baby. Do you want to come and have a look at it?
No.
Hmm.
I'll come and have a look. Come on, Harry, let's go and have a look at Grandad's.
I'll come and look at your chair. I
didn't ask you to. I was just sitting on it chilling.
Unbelievable. You can make me a nice cup of tea for that horrid remark you just made.
Isn't that? This is Olivia's and all.
What?
That's what Olivia got me for Mother's Day.
Oh, lovely.
Needs water. I'm hoping if people know.
These are tulips, aren't they?
Yeah, do these come up every year? I don't know.
What are they?
I don't know.
Are they like bluebells, little bluebells or something?
No.
They're perennials, maybe?
That's what I'm hoping.
Who knows? He's got another football, Sharon. He'll prop that.
How Harry don't mind.
Merlin? He loves popping
Harry
a ball.
Boy down for him anyway.
Did you, Harry? Don't you say much. You're not like your dad, are you?
We don't believe in waffling, do
you? Oh, yeah, he don't waffle. We get straight to the point. Come on, come and have a look at this lawnmower.
Lawnmower,
I've done it, shall. Yeah, it's powder coated. The other one we done was painted, but it's all right. I know it's a textured surface, but being a trotter van, shall, it hasn't got to be A1 paint, you know? Eh?
I said we could put that there.
What for?
That eyesore out a bit.
What, project man, sir?
Yeah.
You've got to be careful. Does that top cover fold down? Because in the wind, don't it spin back? We want to put it against the wall or something. It does, shall. Look, it's on ratchets. There's a ratchet there. You undo that and you can have it flat against the wall or pull it forward, I suppose.
You can split it in half, it's all one.
Yeah, bit. Because if you
I've
just...
I've got a cover coming for it anyway.
Hold on for a minute, baby. If you leave that out in the open, in the wind, that'll go woof like a kite, yeah? So you will be able to undo each end and either fold it flat and then push it against a wall, stand it against the wall over there so that the wind can't get it, yeah?
Yeah. Come on, let's have a look at this lawnmower because we want to get on, me and Harry.
Oh, I don't want to waste your time, baby.
No, we're workers.
Tell me what you think, baby. I want your first impression, shall, when you go in and look at it. It's not finished yet.
Very good.
Come on, baby. Give me some praise. Yeah? Like the other one, isn't it?
Is it exactly the same?
No, I've changed it. It's got trotters, lawnmower engines, because that was the thing with the programme.
There it is. You know it makes sense.
Yeah, I should have already given you credit for that, baby, that you made that. In the video, not in this video. You thought of that phrase, didn't you?
Did you have that, don't you?
Yeah.
Did
you? Yeah, that's the same panel as they got on the side of the van.
Yeah.
But that back bit, trotters, lawnmower engines, that's the thing. See, it's textured. It's
I
all right.
Actually
yeah.
prefer that.
Do you?
Yeah.
Well.
Because to me, it's like their van.
That's what I'm saying to you.
It's more authentic to the trotters.
Right, well, it was unintentional authentic, let's
yeah,
put it that
I
way.
I think that's it, and I think...
Yeah, I'm not going to sell it, we're going to keep this one as well. Going about them, I've tried cleaning these up, baby.
Black, I see.
No, I don't think you want to paint them.
I don't think I want to paint them.
The reason being, if you paint plastic, because they're going to go along the edges of walls and things, they'll scuff and all the red will come off. Whereas if they're scuffed now, because they're red, they're not going to do anything, it'll just be red still. You know, I don't think it matters. They're in good condition anyway, so... I know what you're saying, but I would have preferred it to have been black or even white, but that's
white.
Life. That's the way it goes, Sharon.
What? I was going to say, what's on my mower then? They were gold.
No, I painted them.
Yeah, but they lasted, so this...
Well...
It lasts.
Yours is a bit battered now, your old
your
one.
That's what I'm saying, the black wheels are still intact.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying, go
well, back. They're not fully intact, baby. Come on, out you go. Hold right, on. I think I'll come back in here in a minute, folks. Right, yeah, let's get in there in a minute. So, yeah, we've been busy. It is Bank Holiday Monday today. Now, obviously, there's loads of work that still needs doing in the garden. All this here, for example. I've got to take all this up and then put a concrete plinth down there, build the log cow. I've told this many a time, but things have gone up extra exponentially. Everything's gone up, Harry, isn't it, in price? Eh? You're not like Brilliant Project Man, are you? Hey? Did you say nothing? Unbelievable. Oh, hello. Merlin, come on. Come on. Right, pull them weeds out, shall. Look at Dougal prowling around, shall. Look, he loves it, doesn't he? Hey, don't you, mate? Are you a good boy? Aren't you a lovely boy, aren't you? Hey? Aren't you a lovely boy? Yeah, look how quickly them weeds come up, shall.
I want to get these out of these buckets anyway, but what I just wanted to do was pull these back because I didn't know if it's suffocating.
Well, they can do because the roots, they really provide a big root network on them things. So get them out of the way. And this stuff over there, is that sticky willy stuff or whatever? Yeah, look at that sticky stuff. That's a bloody horrible thing.
Me out in a rush, that,
well, we've got to get all that out and all. Just going around here, lucky enough, we can keep it isolated, hopefully. Terrible stuff, that. But yeah, I mean, we're not gardeners and...
To tell them that they can see that.
No, well, you say that, Shell. When we built the polytunnel 7 years ago, I'd done loads of food in there, didn't I? We'd done loads of food growing and stuff, and I got a series of videos on that on my Retro Restore channel. And that polytunnel actually has done very well over 7 years now. I think it was 2014 maybe when I put it up. And I think that covering what we had on it, I think I've said it before, I only had a 7-year lifespan, but it's been up for over 7 years now. And I did an update video. Now it's obviously a workshop, so it's ideal for growing vegetables in, and it's done really, really well for itself. Oh, that's a bit better, baby. You done well there. Look at all the green fly in there, look. Look, all at the bottom, shall. All little flies.
Oh, I've got some.
They're all over.
I love this. It was going so well. What? And then, of course, I moved it when the weather was nice, and then we had that bad weather again, and the frost has killed it off again.
It's coming back, though. That plant you showed me the other day. That's it, pull it out. Get it all out, baby. Thing is, it does your back in, doesn't it, gardening?
Yeah, I'm not cut out for gardening.
Well, you're nearer the ground than me, shall.
Well, there is that.
Anyway. Even these, I don't even know what these things are, Sharon, look. What? This thing here.
That's them white clear things that dry.
Is it a weed?
I think that is a weed.
But there again, I'm not taking that up because I like it.
Yeah, there's another somewhere in the garden.
Yeah. It's a lovely garden, but as I say, some people like it all with straight edges and borders and everything's got to be tidy. Like, we like a bit of a wild thing because things grow and it's nice to see all the different colours, like a little meadow, as you say. Yeah, pull all them out, shall. I normally go over there with a lawnmower, you see, and it takes everything out. But
where does that sticky stuff come from?
I don't, well, it's one of those plants, shall, isn't it?
Oh, horrible.
Isn't it? One of those plants.
You want a big glove?
And it sticks to you, doesn't it? And it sticks to the dogs.
Hungry, yeah.
Hey?
And I'm getting out of the glove.
Hello, what's he doing? Is he going to be sick?
Yeah, he is.
Oh, look.
My baby.
Oh, he's going to heave, look. Oh, he's going to chuck up. What's he eating?
He's eating a lot of grass there, he says.
Has he? Oh, poor Dougal. Let's see if he brings up some grass, folks. Merlin, come away. Merlin, get away.
When you're being sick, don't you? You need him like Owen there.
Leave him alone, Merlin.
Come away, Merlin. I know you're concerned.
Oh, that's grass. He's sicked up grass, Sharon. Hey, did they eat that grass to make him sick, I think? Didn't they? Someone told me once. You all right, Dougal? Hey? Oh, poor little Dougal, Merlin. He's just been sick. If they don't feel well, I was told they eat grass to make themselves sick, Sharon. What are you going to do?
I'm just going to hold him purple.
I think he's going to go again, isn't he? Yeah, he's going to go again. Oh, poor Dougal. You can't do nothing, folks. You just got to let them get on with it. Go on. Stick it out, mate. Yeah. That'll be alright. Is that alright, mate? Hey, come on. Come on. Dougal. You little face, look. What's he doing, Merlin? Hey? Has he been sick? Hey? Has he been sick? Good boy, Dougal. There you go, mate. Yeah. You're not well. Did you make yourself sick, eh? Good boy. Come on in. It's funny how he just turned his back on the shower, wasn't it? And done it over on his own.
Look, I'm wagging his tail now, not running about.
I know. That would be shower. I'd be straight on the sofa. I'd want medicine.
Yeah.
I'd want a bleeding hot cup of tea, and I'd put my feet up and I'd be there all afternoon.
Dougal, what's up,
Paul? He's out and about again, look. Look, Merlin, down. Merlin, down.
Leave him alone, Merlin.
Yeah, amazing how they do that, isn't it? That's like when the dog goes for like the vet or whatever, shall. Yeah? And like if they have their testicles off or something like that, they're running about the next day or even later that day, shall. If I had mine off, shall, I'll be in bed for a month. Anyway, right, let's go inside, folks. And I'll see you in a minute. Who's just turned up, folks? Look.
Browned everything.
Unbelievable. Where you been?
Been working on a car.
Oh yeah, is that why you need to borrow my tools again, as everyone noticed?
It was just your jack, mate, I'm afraid. I've got my own tools out of the
Did you not take the top on?
No.
Yes, you did.
You're watching the video.
You asked for it, you asked to borrow it early on.
I borrowed the jack, that was it.
Alright, folks, we were going to do the air fryer video today, but we've actually done the video, me and Sharon, but it's quite a long one, so I thought I won't take it on the end of this one. Oh, look, here she comes now, look, my little baby, look. You've been down the road, baby?
Yeah.
I'm just telling them, we've done the air fryer video, which I was going to put on this video.
What?
Oh, hello. What's going on there?
Hey? I'm too short, aren't I? Get down.
Burn it down now. So I'm going to put that on a dedicated video, because it's quite a long video. Is that all right with you?
It's all right, love. You're the boss. You're the director. I'm just the star.
Shout, I'm not the boss. We're 50-50 partnership. I've told you that before, baby.
He's only in my parking, babe.
What?
I've got to get off. He says, I want to finish the video first.
Hey, say that again, or what?
I said I was going to get the van off, but you said, I want to finish the video.
I want you to look at your face when you see that.
Shout, that's not the face I make. Is it, Shout? Yeah, don't make that face. Anyway, wouldn't it great the air fryer, Shout?
Oh, got he's got one now, hasn't he, as well?
Who?
Jimmy, Gary.
Yeah, he does everything we do, doesn't he?
I might have suited.
We're trendsetters, Shell.
Low life, look.
Low life?
Oh, no, live life.
Live life, Shell, not low
only
life.
Half the carbs.
Is it, though? Good. Where's the old thing on the back there?
It's only because it's quarter of the slice of
food. Well, per slice, 3.4 grams, yeah, so that's 6 grams. On a low carb diet, you're allowed about 33, 40, 50, under 50 grams a day, basically.
Yeah, half a loaf,
though, aren't we? No, not half a loaf. I don't know what gluten-free is, though. Is that the same, is it?
I don't think this has got life in it. It's squidgy.
Yeah.
Gluten-free stuff's always a bit, isn't it?
Yeah.
Hard.
Yeah. It's and a very dry consistency, I find.
This isn't bad, this bread. So I was thinking I might have soup for tea after doing that.
Yeah, I've had air fryer food today, folks. We was doing a demonstration, as I said. I was going to put it on this video, but I think you'll be happier if we put it in its own dedicated video.
But you've got to like, share and subscribe.
And also like, share and subscribe.
Otherwise we won't put it up.
Otherwise we will put it up, baby, because it's our job.
Well, let's try and get people to like, share and subscribe.
Yeah, all right. I know, baby.
And more viewers.
Anyway, well, thanks very much. A nice little bit short, baby, this video, isn't it? Hold on.
Like me.
He's down there. He's
showing.
I'm teaching them to sit at the door, aren't I, by not coming in.
He's actually very good.
Because they're not... Google. Get down, Merlin. Out. See if it works. Out. Sit. Merlin, sit. Merlin, sit.
Usually does.
Shout. Merlin, sit. Sit. Merlin, sit. Merlin, sit. Good boy. Good boy. He did stick his tongue out. He's doing it again, look. So we're trying to, when I'm filming, as I say, they was in and out of the kitchen, and I've done that, and I walked away like this. So stay. Stay.
I've got a room
down here. There we go. Stay. Look. Project man.
Brandy, sit.
Yeah, look. See, they're still there. Look. See, they can be trained. Stay. Good boy.
Yeah, look,
stay.
I'll try and take in the
van. Oh, I've hit my head.
I've
hit my head, Shell.
Look,
look.
Look, he's not swearing.
Hey.
Mark, hold three on, watches I've got.
Have you?
Yeah.
She's listed something on eBay, folks. We'll tell you about that.
I've not done this for years.
In a different video. We'll tell them about that in a different video, Val.
Yeah, because I'll be doing
Val, I called you Val.
Who's Val?
I don't know. A shower. It's like a shower with a vowel missing. Anyway, let me go outside. Project man wants me, Sharon. See you in a minute. What's he got out here? What you got in here?
Just come out of action for a bit of action.
Oh, my God. Look, it looks brand new. I bought you for... Oh, hello. That's how blinking long it's been in there. Look, they've gone rusty. Unbelievable.
What I do?
It's actually seen some work for once.
Yeah, I picked this up the other day, look. It's handy to keep in the van for when I get to pick mowers up.
Oh, that's, what is it?
It's a ratchet socket.
Right.
Well, it goes from 8 to 12 at that end and 17 to 21 at that end.
How do you adjust the size for it?
Different sizes, so it pushes in, see?
Oh, right, okay. Oh, I see. Yeah, because sometimes when we go to pick a mower up, sometimes the handles have got non-standard bolts on.
Yeah.
And it's just a little handy tool. Is it Parkside?
Yeah, Aldi, is it?
How much was that?
£9.
Is it Lidl or Parkside? I can't remember. Lidl. Lidl's Parkside.
We went to the one next to that McDonald's. What's that?
I don't know. I forget what Aldi's make is. It's Parkside. I'm sure Parkside is Lidl. I'm sure they'll tell us in the comment section.
Lidl.
It is Lidl, yeah. Yeah, so it's worth looking in the aisle. You don't want to leave your best stuff in the car, obviously. So, I mean, something like that is very handy to just keep in there as a standby thing, isn't it?
Well, that's what I do. I can put these back in storage now.
Hey?
Put these back in storage now.
Yeah, use mine.
Yeah.
Halfords Advance. Look at that, look. Fantastic. Okay. Nice to see it used for one. Is that mine?
No, that's mine, that. Look. What, this?
Yeah.
That's mine, look.
Oh, you've got a set of that. See, it's all brand new gear. Look, it's not used.
I don't like using it, do I?
Unbelievable. And he's using mine all the time, folks. But there again, that Audi, not Audi, the Halfords Advanced stuff, it's got a lifetime guarantee. Oh, what's this? The car you just serviced.
Yeah.
Had a fault code up, didn't it? And what was it? The air hose split. And how much did that cost?
£89, I think.
Look at that, for that blinking hose, folks. Look, off of the air intake, no doubt. And it probably went for the, what did it start playing up, did it, or what?
Yeah, Went in limp mode.
Went in a limp mode, and that's what it was. Look, a couple of splits in that hose there, look. 89 quid, and that's a Honda part, isn't it?
Yeah.
And they probably, I don't think they make a pattern part for it, do they? Did you check?
That went to a two garages again. They couldn't work it out.
Unbelievable. What is it with garages? To say, that's a friend of his, and they took it to two garages, and they said, what do you mean they couldn't work it out?
It just said something about mass airflow or something.
Right.
So they just reset the lights, so she drove 500 yards down the road, back in limp mode again.
Unbelievable, isn't it?
They just reset the codes, and that was it.
Yeah, well, there you go. Well, I'm afraid garages now, not all of them, I'm not saying all of them, I'm not putting them all under one umbrella. A lot of companies, especially the larger companies, tend to be just part changers now. You've got your small independent garages, they do try to help people out. But your large corporation garages, it seems to me they're just interested in just changing parts. And if it don't work, it's not their fault. You'll bring your car back and you'll change another part. Isn't it?
Yeah.
Anyway, I've had enough part changing today. For, I've got a right splitting headache now.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm going to go inside. Thank you very much for watching, folks. And we'll see you in the next video. Don't forget, check out our other videos. We've got a playlist that we'll leave at the end there. You can see all our family vlogs and stuff like that. He normally appears in some of it. But he has got his own channel, if you probably know that. Project Man. And my other channel is Retro Restore. And that's where I fix stuff and play about with small engine stuff and cars and motorbikes and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah.
And that's what we do. Anyway, thanks very much, folks. We'll see you in the next video. And until then, bye for now.